it felt like something that was just sort of slowly coming together under its own steam, you know, of its own accord.
It just feels like my natural voice in a way to work with these darker colors, you know, with these sort of more muted, more kind of black and white colors. And, you know, I can't really explain why, you know.
It's an album that I've been working on, you know, since 2009, really. I recorded bits and pieces here and there, just sort of slowly adding to it. You know, I didn't have a deadline, I didn't have any kind of, you know, external pressure. It was just music that was kind of becoming on its own, you know, becoming itself under its own volition in some way.
And then sort of slowly sort of other ideas began to emerge. It was one piece that I wanted to write for vocals, and then I started to look for a text, and I looked into Ovid's Metamorphoses, and particularly his retelling of the Orpheus myth.
It's the story of a poet who is in love with Eurydice. Eurydice dies, and she goes to the underworld, to Hades. Orpheus is such a great poet that the gods allow him to go into the underworld to bring her back on one condition, on condition that he doesn't look back. But he breaks that promise and looks back at his Eurydice because he can't resist it. And that results in Eurydice, you know, going back to Hades, to the underworld. And so Orpheus is left alone. You know, it's about mutability, about change, about transition. You know, transitioning from one state to another, from you know, like a dream to wakefulness, or from you know, the night into day. And it's also about our relationship with the dead, how we relate to the memory of the dead.
So slowly the Orpheus myth kind of became almost like the central metaphor for the album, and almost for the process of the album as well, this sort of process of change, process of metamorphosis, you know, process of mutability and death and rebirth. I started to think of Jean Cocteau's film Orphée, which is a retelling of that same myth. I remembered sequences in that film where Jean Marais, as the titular character, is listening to these strange broadcasts in his car radio.
39, 40.
I decided to incorporate the recordings of the so-called numbers stations, which are these relics of the Cold War, which are sort of similar kind of broadcasts of codes and letters and numbers and this really strange, enigmatic, mysterious series of signals that were sent out. I used some of these voices as like an echo of these coded transmissions that are coming from somewhere, from the underworld, I suppose. With this album, it really started with the music. It started with these ideas, these very simple kind of harmonic ideas that I was working with and kind of evolving and working with in different versions and permutations. And I started working with this sort of ascending harmonic kind of ideas. It was music that seemed to be kind of flowing upwards, you know, in this sort of steady motion. And they kind of slowly multiplied and became this kind of ecosystem of little themes and little ideas that seemed to, you know, evolve into a kind of a world of their own.
my first personal solo album in a few years, and it's an important thing for me. And it's a very personal album. It's very you know, it feels very close to me, and it's great to have this opportunity to put it out. Yeah, it's been part of my life for a few years now, and almost like, you know, it feels hard to let go in some way, because it doesn't feel finished, you know. Somehow the things never seem finished. I mean, that's true for most projects. You never really feel that something is finished. You know, you just have to put a full stop somewhere, you know.